Hello friends, today it's one of the most misunderstood topic in physics, time dilation. First, we will see what is time dilation with an analogy and then why it happens. And I confidently say that I can keep this also simple. For many, it's very difficult to digest the idea of time dilation because it's not something that we observe in our day-to-day life. So, let's start with something that is very familiar to us. We have red brothers here and green brothers here standing on their own trailers. And now, they start moving away from each other. And for time being, let us join the tall red brother, see through his eyes and see what is happening. We see that the size of the green brothers reduces when they are moving away. But nothing happened to the size of short red brother since he did not move relative to us. Now, let us join with the tall green brother and see through his eyes. For him, the size of red brothers reduces as he feels they are moving away from him. And the size of short green brother did not change as there was no relative movement. And now, for a moment, let us join the blue man standing on the ground and see through his eyes. For him, the sizes of red brothers and green brothers both reduced. And all these size reductions stopped once movement stopped, whether it be for red brother, green brother, or for the blue man. Let's say, for the tall red man, green man had an initial height. It reduced while moving, and when red man stopped moving, the process of reduction stopped and it became a new constant height. We don't feel any confusion or contradiction with this observation because we have been feeling it or observing it from our birth onwards. Now, let's put a clock with red team and green team and let's join red brothers once again and see through their eyes. Everything is fine. We see both clocks ticking at the same rate and now they start moving. What happens then? The red clock is not moving relative to us and so the red clock ticks at the same rate. But the green clock is moving relative to us and appear ticking slower to us when we look from red man. That is, from the perspective of red man, the green clock or the time of the green man passes slowly or time dilates, like the height reduced. Now the movement stops and once again the clocks are back to normal rate. But now there is a time offset between the clocks as seen by the red man, like there was a difference in height. So during this event, from the perspective of red man, time lapsed for red man was normal and the time lapsed for green man was lesser. This is called time dilation. And now, let us join green men and see through their eyes. For them, their clock was steady and like the height of red brothers reduced for them, from their perspective, the clock of red brothers was ticking slower. Or, for them, time passed slowly for red brothers. Now, how was it for blue man? For blue man, his time was steady and the clocks of both red and green brothers ticked slowly. Or, time slowed down for both, like the heights of both reduced. Today, we have many evidences to say that time dilation is real. But we don't feel it in our day-to-day life only because the relative speed required for substantial time dilation is too high that with the current technology, we cannot travel at that speed. Here, let's say the red brothers start traveling at an imaginary high speed of 2.6 lakh km per second relative to blue man. Blue man stands there unmoving and let's say 20 years passes for blue man. By this time, red brothers take a big round and return at the same speed. But due to time dilation, time would have passed slowly for them and red brothers would have aged only 10 years and everything including their breath, movements, etc. were normal for red brothers and they would be surprised to see an aged blue man when they returns. That's how the time dilation happens. Let's stop this analogy here because it breaks further. Next question is why it happens. Let's start with another familiar situation where this man is walking at a speed of 10 meters per second inside a train. For another person in the train, he travels at 10 meters per second. Now, The train is actually moving with a speed of 30 meters per second, and so the speed of the man for another person standing in roadside is 40 meters per second. And in fact, the train is moving on the surface of Earth, and Earth itself is moving at a high speed compared to Sun. So, for a person on the Sun, the speed is much, much higher. And our solar system itself is moving at a high speed compared to our galaxy Milky Way. So, for an observer outside our solar system, the speed of man will be much more higher. And the question now is, if it goes like this, can the speed be infinitely high for another observer? Or is there any limit for the highest speed which can be observed by any observer? And the answer is yes, there is a limit for the highest speed, and that is 2.99 lakh km per second. Why this limit? Well, it's the rule of nature. We have just found it out. That's all. And there is one thing around us which is very familiar to us that travels at this speed relative to everything. It's light or electromagnetic wave. And so, this highest possible speed is often referred as speed of light in vacuum. What does it mean? It means that if somebody torches light somewhere, the speed of that traveling light observed by all people would be 2.99 lakh km per second, irrespective of whether they are at rest, traveling towards it, or away from it, and so on. No arguments on this, because this has been experimentally demonstrated a number of times. Now, what is the after effect of this? Let's see another situation where I am standing on Earth and my friend sitting inside a spaceship is moving at a very high speed relative to me. Remember, sitting inside his spaceship, he doesn't feel any movement inside, and it is as if you are reading a book on a smooth train. Now, he just lights his torch for a moment and produces a light pulse like this, and he notes the position of the clock handle when the light pulse started and when it hit the ceiling. And this is the path of the light pulse, and distance traveled by it in this time is simply this height. Now, I was also looking at the same light pulse but from Earth, and I also found the same positions of his clock handles when pulse started and hit the ceiling. But for me, the path of light was different and like this. Or the distance traveled by the light when the clock handle moved for the same ticks was higher for me. Now, we know that the speed of light should be same for him and me. That means the light traveling at the same speed covered shorter distance for him and longer distance for me. So, naturally, the light should have taken more time for me to reach the ceiling, since it had to travel larger distance. Yes, light had taken longer time for me, but his clock ticked the same time interval for him and for me. What does it mean? It means that his clock ticked slower for me. There is no other possibility. To quantify, if my friend had travelled at 2.6 lakh km per second, for me, his clock's seconds handle would take 2 seconds of my time to move one position. Or his clock took more time to complete 1 second and thus got slower. When I say his clock became slower, it's not only his clock, but his heartbeat, breathing rate, and everything appeared slower for me. But my friend did not know this, and everything appeared normal to him. This is how time dilation happens. And there is one more reason other than relative speed for time dilation, that is gravity. Or it means that if I am on a planet of higher gravity, time would move slower for me. A detailed explanation on that, let's keep it for another episode. Subscribe, click the bell button, and be with us. Signing off, Science for Common Man.